Hey everyone, in today's video we're going into how to make highly profitable Facebook ads quickly and easily in 2019 for beginners. Let's go right now. All right, and just before we get into it everyone, don't forget to like, share, subscribe and hit that notification bell, and let's get straight into teaching you how to make profitable Facebook ads quickly and easily in 2019. Okay, so this is working off the pretext that you already have your ads manager set up. That's in another one of my videos and in a future video upcoming. But let's go ahead and make an ad right now. So all we do is we choose create an ad. You can choose use an existing campaign. We want to create a new campaign. There's different types of campaigns. We're doing e-commerce marketing. So for us, we don't do any of these. We just want to go for conversions, which is drive valuable actions on your website, in your app, or in Messenger. So for us, this is converting people from Facebook onto our store into paying customers, okay? So we choose conversions. And down here, it's gonna have a bit more of an explanation, and it's gonna try and encourage you with different options. You just wanna ignore that. You wanna give it a name. So let's call this test campaign. We don't want to create a split test, and we don't want to do budget optimization. If it asks you to make an ad account, then just go ahead and make an ad account, okay? So moving on, now we're at the actual ad set level. So this is the part where we're now telling Facebook the type of individuals that we're targeting, whether they're male, whether they're female, their ages, the location, where they're from, the very device that they're on. This is where we tell Facebook where these people are going to see our ads and who they are, okay? So we're telling Facebook that specifically. So you give your ad set a name, so we're gonna call it test ad set, all right? And we wanna choose what's called a conversion event, okay? And a conversion event is really important because you're telling Facebook what you want to achieve. There's many different types here, but don't worry, it's not really that confusing. You don't need to use most of these. In fact, you only really need to use purchase. Okay, so track purchases on checkout or flow completions. Okay, so what we're telling Facebook here in this is that we're telling Facebook that we want purchases. Okay, so our goal as business owners for an e-commerce store is we want people who are going to buy our product. So we tell Facebook that we want people to come and buy our product, and that's where you want to start. If you do get this, the whole setup of conversion, or that you're not optimized, any little message under here, ignore it. It's fine, there's nothing to worry about, okay? Because it's basically because the pixel doesn't, your actual pixel doesn't have any data at this stage. And because of that, it thinks it wants data, but we have to start somewhere, so it's gonna be fine, nothing to worry about there. Okay, so then we scroll down. We don't use dynamic creatives, and we're not using the other form of conversions at this stage. Now we're up to the actual audience. So we're gonna tell Facebook where we're going to market to. So firstly, we wanna choose people who live in, so we wanna tell Facebook people who live in this location to start with. Okay, and now we wanna tell Facebook who we wanna market to. Now, where most sales come from is from the United States, okay? So we wanna add the United States, okay? And as a country to start with, we wanna add United Kingdom, we wanna add Australia, okay. Australia, Canada, and New Zealand. Okay, and we target these countries because they're all first world countries that have the biggest spending pockets, okay? And they're the most likely to buy your product that you're promoting to them. So we start with those five countries, all right? And we do ages 25 and up. There's a very simple reason for that, is that 24 and under year old men and women don't have as much money and are less likely to convert. You want to start at eight and higher ages because they're more likely to convert first. Now, for what we do with e-commerce, most e-commerce businesses are centered predominantly around women, okay? So you can start by just taking out men. It depends on the product, of course. So at times you have to use, you know, if you're doing motorbikes, if you're selling something related to motorbikes, it's highly likely it's men. If it's, let's say, jewelry, then it's likely women, okay? So you have to use a little bit of just your common sense of what you believe is the gender. If you're not sure, just leave it all, but try and always narrow that down where you can. I'm going to go women in this instance. We're going to, we always want to choose English all so that we get people that are speaking English. The reason is that as well is that obviously in all these countries we have people that speak foreign languages. We want people that speak English because our store is in English language. Okay, so that's really important that we have that because it can mean the difference between a conversion and not a conversion or a sale. Okay, if you're not familiar with that. Well, now we're up to the detailed targeting. So we've told Facebook where, age, gender, and language. Now we want to tell Facebook specifically who, you know, like what these people are interested in. So I'm going to use an example of an item I've seen a lot, an LED dog collar, okay? So it's a dog item, all right? So we just use Facebook because it comes up with autocorrect option, auto find options. So we've got now dogs, okay? And we can see how every time we're narrowing the audience just a little bit, okay? So we're just narrowing the audience, the potential reach a little bit. So we're cutting out most of the people and we're making it more specific so Facebook can find the right type of individual. So if we go dogs, and again, if we go something other else dog related, because when we narrow an audience, what we're telling Facebook is that someone that likes option A, that's interested in option A and B. And you can go C, D, E, F, G, you can go as detailed as you like. But every time you do a narrow down of an audience, you're telling Facebook that these people have to meet, that they have to like this, they have to like that. You can add multiple interests within an ad set, so they could like any one of them. They don't have to like any of all of them within it, just one of them to meet the criteria, okay? So that's really important to know. So you can add as many as you like, and then you could narrow it down with a similar interest, okay? So if we put in dog magazine, okay? So we could do dog magazine, all right, American Dog Magazine in this instance, and you can see how that's dropped the reach quite a lot. That's probably not an example we're going to use. We're going to use a well-known brand called PetSmart. Okay, so you can see how, look at that. So we've just narrowed our audience even further. In fact, by now it's about a quarter, less than a quarter. So we've narrowed it down majorly just by doing this. So now we've told Facebook. Now, these people, you can say to yourself when you're making this ad that these people are likely to be interested in LED dog collars because they're into dogs, they like dogs, and they like PetSmart, which is directly also related to dogs as a whole as well. All right. So now it is a general recommendation to not use this option here. This will only increase your reach majorly, and it does not help at all. Okay. So I do not recommend using that. Scrolling down, we want to go edit placements, okay? And we go edit placements, and we want to take out desktop, okay? Desktop is far more expensive to market to, especially at early stages on low budget, okay? You don't want to market to desktop. You want to market to mobile, just take out desktop because most people buy on mobile now anyway. We also want to narrow it down a little bit further. You got all these placements. So these are areas where you can actually place, and Facebook's going to have like a little preview of each one and the placement and what the image looks like or video looks like in each of those placements. But when you're starting out, the main two ones is Facebook and Instagram feed, okay? Because those are the ones where most people are on. When they open up Facebook, you're automatically on the feed. When you open up Instagram, you're automatically on the feed. So those are the ones that most people will get marketed to. So what we do is we simply untick any of the other ones that we don't need yet. The reason that we do this is simply because we're trying to maximize our budget. So if we're spending $5 a day, we're telling Facebook that we want it to be on Instagram newsfeed or Facebook where most people actually convert the best. That's another little secret for you, is that most people convert best on Facebook feed or Instagram feed for the most part. And We just want to remove those other factors so that 100% of our budget goes to where we want it to for the highest chances of getting sales, okay? Whereas, you know, spending 5 to 15% of our budget wasted on all these other areas that we can come back to down the line. But starting out, this is how you want to set it up, okay? It's as simple as that. Now, you can specify as well the type of mobile device. This is not recommended to do until way down the line, okay? This is a video to get your ads set up. Just leave it as it is. I don't recommend only when connected to Wi-Fi. That has not been, I have not found it to make any difference personally. So there is no need to have that ticked. Okay, so now we get down to the budget and schedule. Okay, so here we can actually set different types of options for Facebook to try and help our ad for, okay? Now, we don't want landing page views. We don't want others. We want, again, conversions. We want people that are going to come for that. And Facebook suggests that because we're doing a conversion-related campaign. It wants us to optimize for conversions, all right? And if you get a message like this, ignore that. That's completely fine. It is nothing to worry about. Once you start getting data in, that message will disappear. It's not going to affect anything at all. It's just that because you don't have that existing data, that message appears, okay? So the other part that you want to do is you don't want to set cost control options. You don't need to do that, okay? You don't need to do that at all. You can also have a look at the advanced options. You don't want to do budget and schedule. You want to set your budget to $5 a day. When you're first making an ad set, you want to set it to $5 a day, starting low, and then you're going to build on that as you start getting sales in your store, okay? So start at $5. Now, that's $5 in your currency as well, all right? Now, if you do want to try and make the equivalent of US, I suggest just using a currency converter, but otherwise, just make it $5. That's fine. The last thing that you want to do is change it from the conversion window. So select the amount of time it typically takes for someone to complete a valuable action. So we don't want people to convert 7 days later. We want them to convert the same day that they've seen our ad. So I just go 1 day after clicking. Okay. All right. So that is how you set up a highly profitable Facebook ad set in 2019. Okay, guys. In a future video, we're going to be going into how to set up an actual ad creative. Where we're going to be doing a full discussion on that, how to set up the campaign, how to set up the actual ad itself, the copy that we use, the text, do we use a video, do we use an image, and we're going to go into an in-depth discussion on that in this ongoing video tutorial to help you start from where you are to go into an expert. Okay, guys? Everyone, hope you enjoyed today's video on how to set up highly profitable Facebook ads quickly and easily in 2019, okay, guys? Now, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my videos so that you get weekly value delivered straight to you, okay, guys? There's a lot of value, and I'll be giving a lot more of that in this ongoing tutorial on how to set up Facebook ads and so much more. I highly recommend that you check out all my other videos as well. There is so much value there for you to go from where you are in your journey through to an expert and start absolutely crushing it in 2019. Okay, guys? Thank you so much for your time. Have a lovely day. Take care.